Okay, is that sound now? Let me know if we have sound yet. I'm slightly behind. No murmurings. We can't have that. I'll tell you what, I can test it on here. There's me being efficient. I turned the sound down on my phone. Hooray! Yeah, so I always forget and then stop and go, oh, I have to turn the sound down on my phone. Well, it keeps going round. This time I remembered. Ah, I should watch out for the poorly interpreted subtitles. Where was I? Oh yeah, so, this is a fairly simple image. I'm going to be sort of cutting out, I'm not going to have the whole of the plate on or anything like that. This is going to be the edge of my bottle. I think I might make the bottle about that wide, but if I think about the triangle that the bottle and the salt cellar go into, I can see that. It's sort of like this. So I can make that a bit bigger actually. I'll have to move the bottom down to make it bigger. And that put the edge of the salt cellar there, so maybe somewhere in between. Anywho, that gives me a rough idea of the shape of that bottle. I can even measure it. That's about 3 to 1. So I'll take thirds out of that back here. That's roughly a square. So the bottle fits into that shape. Let's do that one more time, see if I can place this salt cellar. Should be down here somewhere. My salt cellar gives me an idea of things. Yeah, I want to keep going with the. Oh, hello, Jason. Ah, I want to keep going with the brand thing. I quite like the idea of recognisable labels. And I had this turned around slightly earlier, just for some interesting light. That's too straight on. No, maybe a bit more like that. That's a bit more like it. Yeah, lots of light on the label now. I'll pop a little bit of blue in there. And I'm going to look for some shadows. Just go up like that. Move that on the side. Be over there. It's going to go off there. So that bit of the triangle is going to actually be edge of the plate now. Shadow comes off here. That fork gonna go roughly parallel, so I'll move it out a bit. Now here they are again. Yeah, that's roughly the fork there. That's rather fun. Yes, it's funny, isn't it, how we have a prejudice against squeezy bottles, even though they're just far better. The old glass ones. I suppose you really had to earn your ketchup in the old days, didn't you? Right. Might change the colour behind a bit later on. First of all, let's say that's that background layer, level layer, what am I talking about? Is about there. That's about. Yeah, and there's this sort of, what is it, octagonal format to the actual bottle itself, which is hopefully going to show up. But yeah, no, it had to be an iconic glass bottle. That's the whole brand thing, isn't it? I imagine they still use them plenty in the advertising, and then they sell it in squeezy bottles, because then you can actually get the ketchup out. Rather than bruising your hand. All right, keep this vague at the moment. Drawing's in pretty quick, and I'm fairly comfortable with it. So, I don't know if that's a bad sign. Fairly comfortable with that. Let's have a look for another colour to go in the background. I think it needs to be something sympathetic to the green on the plate, which will give a contrast to the red of the ketchup bottle. Not too light and not too strongly coloured. Let's see what we can find. You can help me decide. Is that too light? I think it is. I want this side of the ketchup bottle to look light. Perhaps I need a dark colour for that to happen. I think I probably do. I'll stick with this one. I'll maybe just soften it slightly. See if I can get away with. But no, that does need to be dark. All of this is going to get a bit darker. Yeah, so this is going to be very much a tonal painting, I think. The other thing is knowing where that label is. That's going to be really helpful. Because actually everything's going to work around the label. That's definitely my focal point. That's what I want everyone to be looking at first. So I've got to decide where that goes. It's going to be tricky because there's an idea, you'll think of it straightened up, but how it appears might be slightly different. Let's put a line across there. Far off, it's a bit steeper than that. Be higher up. Maybe that heel at the bottom needs to be higher up. Yeah. Yeah, maybe thin it down ever so slightly. Let's try that. There. The shape of the bottle is also going to be very recognisable. If it's slightly too squat, it's going to show. If it's too thin, it's going to show as well. Oh, hi Terry. Good to have you along. Okay, I'm going to do something I don't normally do, and certainly tell people to avoid it if they can. And that's put in a thin wash of light, but I think it's going to be necessary. And it's such a small amount of paint. I tell people not to do this because they'll chuck a whole load of white on at the drawing stage and then it's you end up with this very thick paint that just makes everything everything look white afterwards. But it's going to be very useful to see that light. Figure out the shape of that fork, so I'm not going to worry about it. Not yet. Okay, there's going to be some light in here. Try and get that shape. Maybe stick a little bit more in. Now I have to allow for this later on when I'm painting over it. It's going to mix with whatever paint I'm putting on top. Also put in the shape of some of this label. And some of the cap and the top label. Yeah. So that's going to be quite useful. So I can see that okay now. I can see the image starting to turn up. So that's quite fun. I'm going to get a scrubby colour on for the background. This is going to be slightly thinned and easier to work against when I put the bottle in. So, yeah, still not quite right, is it? It needs to be. Maybe that bottle over. Yeah. Okay. So getting ready for the next stage of painting now, which is quite fun. I don't know what kind of accent I'm meant to speak in for the Facebook subtitle bot to understand me. I think I'm speaking English, but maybe without the California drawl it's unintelligible to the poor thing. So. I will not be starting any videos with the words, hey guys. Or if I do, you'll know I'm making fun. Right. So this relates to my background colour. It's going to have to get greener. And even still a little bit viridian to chuck in there. Just to be extra cheeky. And push it over to the green, but keep it quite neutral. Okay, I trust there's no shine coming off that. Hooray, that's good. Okay. Now, just as a little preparation, I'm going to try and get this family going here. I'm going to do the light red this side and the dark red this side. So I'm going to get some alizarin. And some blue. That's too much blue. Let's put that back there. Oops, some alizarin. This is going to be almost at the black stage here. I've got some burnt umber for later on as well. Yeah, it's going to get pretty dark, but maybe not quite that dark. I still want to be able to see the colour. Give it the push. There we go. So that's my dark side of the bottle, and I want to see that contrast between that and here. And I can even try them out next to one another. And it's not huge, which means this needs to get a bit lighter, I think. So if we go back over here, and it's still not really light. I still need the contrast between the red and the white, a bit yellow ochre in there. Quite a brown colour, that catch-up colour. It's a little bit lighter towards the edge. So let's give it some. That's as light as I'm comfortable with at the edge. And that's a good contrast. I'm fairly happy with that. So I don't want to shift this very much. Excuse me. Oh, hi Mark. You made it. Good stuff. Good to have you along. Okay, let's see what we can do with this colour then. I've still got a little bit of white on the brush, so. See how that looks. Let's pop a bit on. Actually, I think that's okay. It does need to be greener though. I'll leave a little patch of it so I can compare it tonally. Let's chuck a whole load more green in there. Definitely greener. Yeah, chuck the rest of it in. I'm going to thin this slightly so it's quite a dead colour. I don't want it to be too... Oh. Yeah, just the spirit that's on the brush should be fine. Is that too much? No, it's okay. Hey. Yeah. So accentuating the greenness ever so slightly. Not being too fussy about shape. That will come. And then I'm going to lighten it as we go across. So this is in the middle. I'll do a dark one first or a lighter one first. Might have to go across the two brushes. Also, I'll probably mix some more of this to change the edge of something somewhere as we go along. Hey. So yeah, I'll get another brush, another decent sized brush actually, let's use this one. Let's borrow a little bit of that red, just to darken this off. It'll also neutralise it a little bit. Still a green. It is now the most unusual of things, a ready green. Now, I'm not worried about breaking that edge. Okay. This other brush, let's go a tiny bit. Hey, add a little bit of yellow ochre to it. The tiniest bit of white. It's too strong a green. It's upsetting me. That's a bit more neutral. Fairly happy with that. That was too much yellow ochre. A dab of red in there. A little bit of blue maybe. A little bit lighter just as I get across to this side over here. Yeah, that bleaches out some of the yellow, so that's good. Come on. I'm saving it for a better easel. This has only got one solid bit in the middle, which means a small canvas offset so that you can get the best camera angle. It has a flappy side, which is where I'm at now. And it's It's flapping around. Great. Just while that's there, I'm just going to put a few shapes in here. The lights will go over the top, but you get a general idea of the shape. See that now? That's not quite right. That's the middle of the plate there. Bit of symmetry. Ta-da! Great. Okay. So I'm just winging it with the ellipses there. The boy racers will be round again. They have very little imagination in terms of routes. I'm sure they're not changing it up much. So they'll be along. There's some chap with a motorcycle as well. He's terribly pleased with how loud that is. So I expect we'll be hearing him too. Can't wait. yeah, it's a... It's good. That's what this live stream has become known for. It's the one with the boy races in the background. I like that angle. I'm going to keep it. He says, "I'm going to move that down a bit." Very subtle. Yeah, softened it ever so slightly. Ah. So yeah, I'm liking this green already, that's rather fun. That bottle is going to expand out here. So that edge will be okay. Right. Oh, great. Okay, I'm going to give myself a moment to think before I mix the next colours. Them back. And clear myself a space for the next colours I mix. I don't know where my bin is. Yeah, I'm going to plug my phone in and find my special bin. Found it. There you go. This is getting to be like a work of art in itself. That's the old paint box. Yes, it's I think it's a rule to have your car silencer removed in Sherborne because it needs to be astonishingly loud for the old people to hear you. So, you know, they might be on their way to the hearing aid shop. In which case they're on flat batteries and whatever it is, they're not going to hear it coming. Okay, while this is on the palette, I'm going to put in a few flat areas of colour in the same way. One for the shadow side of the bottle. The bong's already. Negative spaces, pay attention. It's an effort. Across to here and get the nice strong red on. That's too strong, isn't it? It needs to be browner. I'll borrow some of the other side. Pop that in. That's a bit better. This is going to come across. That label is going to be slightly longer. Let's go across to the slightly lighter one. Maybe it's going to come in here. Hard to know which. But both. Okay, I need another. The lights, some of the light, a little bit, just to change my drawing a bit. Got that dark colour coming around, so keep this vague and a bit blurry. Like I say, it comes down a bit lower. I'll put some proper paint on here later and I've got a better idea of where it goes. There you are, soft edges. Forgives all manner of things. Yeah, get a bit of that drawing in. Okay. still not seen that heel on the, what would you call it? Is it a heel on the bottle? Change an angle. Here. I need to see it over here as well. Yeah, that's okay. It's all roughly in the right place. That's quite thin paint, so as the I'll use a little bit for the reflection of the fork as well. Okay, I'm overthinking this. I think most of it, okay. See if I can get it right first time. So let's not fiddle around with that any longer. Let's go straight to mixing some colours for this tablecloth thing. Tea towel. Right, let me get over white. There's a bluey one, and there's the inside the plate. It's a slightly peachy one. A bit more purpley. So I'll go with the bluey one first. Oh, that's some put out. There you go, that's good. A little bit of that green, some of the ambient light, and that's about as light as that's going to get. Some bright highlights. I think I can use a bit of a, what do you call it, artistic license when it comes to the shadows. Make an orange. Add blue to it until it goes into soft purple. Good. That'll be good for a shadow colour. And then I'll do a blue one as well. Darker, more purpley one. I quite like them, they're quite strong colours, these. Everything's a bit gloomy there, isn't it? I'll see if I can brighten it up for you. I think it's all these filters. Subject matter's okay. Just a bit of that shine now. There it goes. Actually, it's shiny. Woo! It's rather fun. Okay. Got a light colour, got a shadow colour, which is probably going to be a mixture of the two when I get there. And I'm going to need. Actual blue colour as well. It's a bit greeny. I'm not going to be afraid of this being a bright, strong colour. It's the most intense version. Make a slightly lighter one here. Somewhere between the two, I think I can do all the work with the blue with those. And actually that orange, that's the other one, that's the other thing I needed. So it's going to be a lot of brush mixes, I think, from there on, but it's okay. Right, little bit of spirit on the brush. How horribly light is this going to be? Oh, that's way too much. I need somewhere for these bright highlights. They're going to be the brightest part. And they're going to be there. So, I've got to take it down from that. So I'll use some of these. Yeah, that's probably about as white as it wants to get. Okay. Yeah, let's just block it in like that. Keep it simple. Chuck it on. Okay, once I improve my posture, I can actually make this a lot better. A bit bluer, I think. To move up. Oh, a bit greener in the background. I like the way whites change around in really subtle ways. You can see all these extra colours in them that aren't literal. If your eye isn't fighting with a strong colour, especially one that's very aware of, you can really see quite a lot of extra things to put in. Okay, I'm going to make an orange version now. Keep it roughly the same tone. Hey, I can really see that colour there as well. I'm not just making stuff up for the fun of it. And then it changes again. Yeah, that looks kind of green again. This carries on around. I can work into that anyway. Then it's bluer. On the inside, especially the underneath. And greener. That's greener. Should be looking for everywhere that these colours go as well. Seeing some of the reflection of the bottle in there too, which is going to be in here, which means I need a bit of that green to go in the background. Maybe that's the green I'm searching for. I do believe it is. It's a lot wider there. Yeah. All sorts of colours. There's some of those highlights to go. Okay, I'm going to get back to that orange. When I say orange, it's kind of purple colour, but I'm calling it orange. Because that's the way it leans within that purple gamut. Where else is there some of that? There's a few bits. Okay. back into the light light, but it's a creamy light now. I'll borrow a tiny little bit of that. Goes here. That creamy light go. I think there's a bit in here. Yeah, it goes in this label. That's even the yellow in there. Fun. I haven't put any details in yet. Only a matter of time. So in here. Yeah, and then that bluey one for the lid. There's a difference. Again, I'm trying to get the colours. If I can get the colours, everything else will make sense. That's the lights for that. There. Everything has to match them there. That's quite fun. Right, where was I? Oh yeah, this purpley colour. I'll put that in first, where it belongs, for the shadows. It's quite purple there. Actually a bit purple at the front of these, and darker. I'll have to darken that afterwards. Yeah. And more orangey at the back. Actually that's much darker at the back. Anywhere else for that before I make the really dark one? An orangey edge to this shadow. This other side of the label is quite a warm colour too. Does that work? I think it does. It needs to look peachy. I can always change that a bit later on. Okay, it's starting to appear a bit now. That's quite fun. I need to make a darker version of this shadow colour though. Go back over here, pop a little bit of green in it. Let's pop that in here. That almost doesn't look darker, but I think it's okay. Have I lightened the shadows? That is possible. Yeah, I have. Right. That's a load of red. That's a load of green. Oh, have I ever done it with the green? We'll find out in a moment. No, I think this works okay. It's green at the bottom of the shadow. And a little bit in there. Okay. Can we go back to these peachy colours and we can start working them in a little bit where they belong into these light areas? Few creases and what have you. Yeah, so there's some. A little bit in there too. Some of those little folds in the detail. Also starting to approach here, I think. Yeah, the main colours of this salt cellar. There's darks to go on. But I think this is a lot of it. I'm still on a number 8 brush here. It doesn't need to get any smaller than that. Yeah, possibly at all. Right. Ah, nearly time for a short break. But I hope that's already kind of recognisable as Heinz tomato ketchup. Let's do some of those darks in. It's just the tip of the brush, it's not even sort of loaded up properly. Definitely for the top. An extra dark mix. Not too purple. Working that now. If the highlights will sort it out when the time comes. What else goes on here? Actually, that colour works perfectly for the reflections on this bottle. Darker though. That goes right up. Yeah, there's more to do. There's slightly more orange shadows. Right here on the tines of the fork. Salt cellar is way too big. Break those edges for it. that's a bit more like it. Actually. Okay, that's definitely getting a bit fiddly now, but weirdly it does an awful lot of the job already. Doesn't need much more. So what I might try and do is be very efficient with my next marks. Just got to cover that with the paint. Yeah, there's a few more of these basics I can get on before I go, because I can absolutely see them on the palette. There's this shadow side here, which is mostly this sort of tone. It travels around underneath a bit, and it's also on that side. Let's see if that works better there. I think it does. Blue and the reflections as they come down. Yeah, need to mix some proper thick paint to get just the right marks on the on the bottle, get the colours in the bottle. And the edges of the plate, a few bits of salt cellar and the fork. Which means mixing up some thick paint and putting in about 10 or 15 strokes at most. That's the plan. I'm going to put the kettle on. I recommend you do the same. If you have a kettle, now is the time to enjoy that privilege and have a nice cup of tea. I really want, yes, I need to have a little break now. Or I'll do something stupid and wreck it. I think the bottom needs to extend down a bit. I can't see it yet. Not properly. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Okay, now we're talking. I'm going to mix some proper quantities of paint. Pretty much trust the drawing I've got. That label's still wrong. Ah! Come on. Yeah. And the bottle can get wider as well, but that's good news. I'm going to want more, a bit more alizarin crimson. Yeah, maybe it's not all the salt cellar being too small. Maybe it's the bottle being... still not quite right. Still. Let's see what I can manage with this. Right. I had my dark red. That was good. I'll mix some more of that. I'll remember to darken it. Hey. That's proper intense. That's too intense, really. Needs to be yellow, a bit more raw on that. Yeah. That's good. I'm gonna put these colours, these reds along the front here. Dark to light. I've got the reflective colour, which is using some of this. Okay, let's get the rest of that. Remember. Let's pick up a bit of that light. There we are, it's a bit bluer. Still not dark enough. Yeah, that's probably about right. And then I've got this much lighter red colour. I'm going to use a bit of cadmium. And then work it down. Oh yes, I could do PG tips, couldn't I? Thanks, Mark. I do have a big box of it. Yes, any suggestions for famous brands for me to do? I don't know how long I'm going to keep doing the brands thing. Needs to be browner. I've got some burnt umber here. I'll put some of that in and see what it does. That's pretty good. And a little bit more alizarin, which is just for intensity. It's still darker than that light version. Oh well, I'll figure that out as I go along. I've got the dark colour. And then there's this colour mixed with this colour, where it's just a bit lighter right at the end. Yeah, that's pretty good. Quite like that. It's a toughie. All of the label colours are lighter than all of these. I'm going to get some of that shadow colour. it's too blue. Every time I say that, I hear my grandmother watching Bob Monkhouse. It's too yellow. Again, these still aren't good enough quantities of paint. Crikey, he's got all of them. A Sherbet Fountain, I don't know if we have those. Branston Pickles are actually a village in Dorset. I know because I've sent Americans there. Horlicks? Who has Horlicks? That's not, yeah. Bovril. I'm familiar with. My mother was fond of foods that tasted disgusting because she had this belief that the worse it tasted, the better it was for you. The chicken and broccoli benzoate was a familiar Thursday treat. Those are options. I'll give those a thought. Yeah, we've got that blue. I'm going to keep some of that up as it is. This, I'm going to make a browner one. Yeah, just that edge of the cap. Yeah, this is going to be brush mixes all the way, this one. Preston. Stop it. I'm trying to concentrate here. Okay, I said I'd base this all around the label, and so I think I will. Which means the bottom of that label is in a different place. I said I'd work in thick paint, so I'm going to do my very best to make that the case. There's these curved edges to the label. I think that's lower down, that's why. Just be liberal about the nonsense I make up. Let's do a darker bluer version. Darker yellow version, sorry, of this green. This sort of gold colour. Yeah, that's not it. Actually green. Some lighter and yellow on the other side, over here. So this is where that white underpainting has to be respected. more to this label. It's really subtle, but it's kind of important to get right. Okay. It's a shadow colour. I have the shadow colour over here, a bit greener. Nonetheless, a bit darker as well. The terminator in the middle, it gets a bit darker still before coming out on the light side. Doesn't really apply here because of the weird hexagonal bottle thing. Okay. I think I can really start to define some of these darker shapes now. I don't know if this is going to be too much, but I can always work it in if it is. That light edge. Shape going underneath. Right under here. And a bit. This is quite fun. Paint's moving around quite nicely. I'm trying to enjoy that. Okay, where else? Yeah, that shape comes out. I'm going to a redder version of it. Is that too much soon? Yeah, that's too bright too soon. Oh, that's too bright. Put some of the dark into it. That's better. Still not dark enough. Borrow a bit of blue as well. This could work, yeah. Flat edge at the top. Nice. It's in there as well. So it turns up down here. A little bit off the edge of the label there. Tomato goes in. That's there. That's all of the red, pretty much. There's a bit that goes in there. Those shadows need to darken up a bit, and that red carries across. But before I do that, let me put a bit more of the red in there. Let's really paste this on now. Yes. Ooh. Okay, we've got that light one I mixed, which is meant to go in here. You know what, I'm going to push that in the other direction. Go across the bluey purpley one. See how that works in here? That should be dark. Oh no, that should be darker. Well, I said before I didn't think that was dark enough. Let's see if this does it. That's a bit more like it. Really strange, the colours you find. The top of that shape is important. Also here. Start a red one further up in here. One just the other side. Let's see how well that works. Hey, that's kind of it. Is that really what I'm seeing? It's not far off, you know. This big red over here needs to sort of work in a bit. And then there's little bits they put on the bottle. A few of those little highlights too. Which will be where. Yep. Where did I have that yellow? That was over here, wasn't it? A slightly lighter yellow ochre one. Greener. greener version here. I don't know if that's working. Oh, I don't want air. Come on, I'm trying to get the brush to keep its shape now. I don't want to fiddle too much here. That's kind of important. That's a much darker green, really crisp green. The Viridian should do this quite nicely. Borrow a bit of that light. Just to make that travel. And this is just going to be a few little dashes. Now the good thing about printed labels is that they generally only use a few colours. There's a lot more full colour printed labels around these days, but it always used to be that they only had a couple of colours at most. Even that was a bit extravagant. So it's sort of quite easy to recreate them. Let's just make a darker, bluer version of this. That everywhere it goes. Very rough. But a few gestures here and there. That's all it takes. Dash. Little leaves. It's very important that the tomato is on the front, otherwise you'd have no idea what it's made of. What was that? Oh, I'm going to borrow some of that green to go in here. Again, being a bit cheeky. I can have some too. And into that dark. It really is a reflection of the colour coming from above. A few highlights and lowlights, like I said before, will really finish off this. I'll borrow some red there as well. What else should we have? Oh, I almost completely forgot. Those same colours are up here, aren't they? Definitely need a better brush now. This one isn't going to do it, can't quite hold its shape. Ah, what's that? No, this is awful. Total pig's ear of that. Make some black, do that label. I have to actually stop and get more colour out. And that raw number. Okay, we'll have a legible Z. dramatic version of the whole thing. Zen is much too big. I'll work some light around it. Use this instead. Remove the edges of the bottle and stuff. Oh, I've missed out the fork and got carried away with the other things. Let's just get the basic shape in. Oh no, we've already got the red on there. Just be a suggestion, which was the whole idea anyway. Okay, I'm mixing a load of black with alizarin crimson and viridian. I'm going to soften it down. Some highlights. I'm definitely going to do some more of this when I'm finished. Can't expect anyone to stay here all night. In fact, has everyone left? No! Still some Yeah, hardcore. To the end. Ooh. Nice pinky colour. Pop that in. Creamy colour, and let's put some of these lights back in here. Maybe long. Oh. Could have done a better job of this, I think. This is definitely one that I would have taken a bit longer on. If I'd just been gradually studying it and working it out. But it's not all bad. Hey, that helps. About along here. You know what I haven't done? I haven't done all the blue stripes. Oh no, you think? That'd take ages. Not so. Bit of oil. Let's go with the light ones first. Put some dark bits in afterwards. Good if the brush kept its shape though, I think that would help a great deal. This is really going to create a sense of scale as well. As we go along here, it'll be much bigger. Oh, no, we've got to get close together here. See if I can do that. Close it together, close it together. Alright, so now if I go into the dark ones, which will go in the shadows. The horizontal ones are going to be far less conspicuous. I can start these in the right place. They'll tell us something about where the edges of the salt cellar are. Yeah. because we've really broken these ones. I'm not going to do them with things along here. Especially dipping into that. I haven't done the edge of the plate either. That's going to be really loose. Okay, back to the light. And then this is a little suggestion. Doing these bits very visible there and there. Not so much on the rest of it. Some of that fork back afterwards. Okay. A reflective bit on that. That was fun. Bright flashy highlights there and there. Maybe some on the fork as well. Bright flashy highlight on the edge of that. That bottle. Oh, and there's a weird goldy one. And it comes in. Is it coming? No. Yeah, I know I've gone really quiet here, haven't I? There it comes in here. Yeah. kind of finishes it off, doesn't it? Okay. A few shapes in the tines of that fork kind of stick out. Reflection of the bottle in the plate. A few more lights in the plate, just slightly peachy. Just kind of go in here. This is going to help define the ellipse as well. They're bluer. That's the 2 hour mark, isn't it? Unless it's midnight. Hope I haven't lost it quite that badly. The plate's weirdly warped, but I actually don't even care that much. That's all right. A few neatenings, I think. One, a good bit of dark in the base, which kind of needs to go in here. Also redefines that edge. Splash of light over there. Someone's got to make another comment because every time I look down it says Bryanston Picker at me. Start to come away again now. I don't know, gives it a kind of a halo effect I rather like. A bit of distortion with the label, but nothing I'm going to worry about too much. The fork actually came out the best. I should have done everything with the same slipshod cavalier attitude that I took to that. Okay. The Dorset knob is fairly unknown outside of the county, as far as I know. But it would make an amusing title. So that might be a good subject. Salt on the top of that. Yeah, I think that's pretty much done. I am going to mix a little bit more of that background colour, I think. Or am I? Have I got the ingredients? That's the important thing. There's some green, there's some yellow ochre. Oh yeah, now I'm out of raw umber, which was one of the main ingredients. And just add blue to it. See if I can use burnt umber. And if I imagine hard enough, maybe it'll do the same thing. I like the extra greenness I'm getting from this. That's quite good. Okay, and at the other side. Yeah, that's okay. I'll get away with that. Things a bit. A bit of a direction. No one cares about that bit of the painting. Leave it alone. It doesn't matter. Sign it. Okay, well that's got to be signed in red really, isn't it? Ketchup red. No, it's not done. There's that edge on the fork. Keeping its shape. Maybe not, in which case I'll do it with this. Okay, that is getting fiddly now. Ta-da! Thanks very much for joining me. I'm going to move the camera now so you can see this. And make an appropriate judgment about in what way I am. Right. Well, sorry about that. There is today's painting, which was rather fun to do. Isn't exactly my eye view, but it's not entirely dissimilar. I had some fun painting that. I hope you had some fun watching me letting my tea go cold. As you can see, I used my artistic license a little bit when it came to the certainly when it came to the tea towel, but it does its job. So yeah. Oh, my tea's gone cold. Hi Dan. Got a rare night off. So a painting to the story of Heinz Tomato Ketchup. Long may it rain. Yeah, that was quite fun. Yeah, I'm not going to fiddle with that anymore. That's the thing with these live streams, is it should be about just the excitement of capturing a moment, but I think the most dangerous thing is when a painting feels like it's starting to go well. That's when you ruin it. And this could have been a lot better had I not tried to improve it during the general process. But just gone through it, just slapping paint on, wondering what I was doing, it probably would have been much better. But yeah. Well, hopefully at least makes you a little hungry. That's all I can hope for. Certainly my cooking is never going to do that, so perhaps if my painting can, that's something I can hope for. Yeah, thank you very much for joining me, everyone, and have a lovely evening, and I'll see you next week for... What was it? Coleman's mustard, maybe? No. No more condiments. Veggie tips wasn't a bad idea. Maybe Kellogg's cornflakes. Yes. Yeah, because that's my staple diet anyway, so it would seem appropriate. but no, it'll be time to change tack to a rather different set of subject matter. Sometime soon. Hopefully the time will come I can get people back in the studio, do some more portraity things and that kind of stuff. So I won't blather on any longer. Thank you very much for joining me, and I'll see you next time.